Good morning, children. This is your computer period and we are going to start with the lesson number 3, that is computer software. Before explaining this chapter, I would like to explain the previous chapter again, that is hardware. What is hardware? Hardware are the physical components of the computer which we can touch and feel. For example, CPU, monitor, keyboard, hard disk, etc. In this picture you can see there are many parts of computer which are hardware, which we can touch and feel. Now what is software and why the software is needed inside the system? To explain this, I would like to take some examples. Children, if I buy a car and I want to run that car, will it work, will it run without fuel? Obviously, I need to put petrol, diesel, CNG or something like that inside the car so that it can run. Same way, if human beings like we want to work, we need energy to work, and for that we have to eat something. We have to eat food so that we have energy and we can work. Likewise, if I want to run a fan, we need electricity. Electricity is not there, the fan will not work. Same way, if we want to run a computer, we need some instructions inside the computer. Without those instructions, the computer will not work. And those specific instructions which are needed to run a computer are called software. So what is a software? Software is a set of instructions given to the computer to do a particular task. For example, MS Word, MS Windows, MS Paint, etc. Children, let us start reading the chapter now. Chapter number 3, Computer Software. Hello friends, in the previous chapter you have learned about different hardware components. Do you know that these hardware components cannot work without a software? Let us learn about some popular software programs. What is a software? Software is a set of instructions that tells the computer how to do a particular task. For example, you draw and color beautiful pictures in MS Paint on the computer. Here, the computer is an example of hardware and MS Paint is that of a software. You can touch the hardware, but you cannot touch the software. Types of software. There are two main types of software: application software and system software. Now in this diagram, we can see different colored circle. And in the previous page, we have read about the different types of software, that is system software and application software. Let me explain a little bit here. See, we can see a circle here inside that is of gray color with hardware. Above that there is a pink circle with the name system software. And above that there is a green circle with name application software. And the word user is written outside the green circle. Now hardware are the physical components of a computer which you have read in the previous chapter. System softwares are the programs which are mandatory to be there in the system. Without system software, a computer cannot work. Right? And above that, there is a green circle, that is application software. These are the software which we choose according to our need. If we want to write a letter, we'll choose a word processor. If we want to write, keep the contents in the table, we'll choose spreadsheet. If we want to do the internet, if we want to surfing in the internet, then we'll choose internet browser. So using these three circles, I think the concept is clear. Hardware are the physical components. To run the hardware, system software is needed. And to do the different types of different categories of tasks, application software are needed. And user is the person who is using the computer system. Now let us read the chapter, the next page of the chapter, that is application software. The software that performs specific tasks for the user are known as application software. These softwares help you in doing some specific types of work. For example, we use MS Paint to make a drawing, but we cannot do calculations using MS Paint. We have to use the calculator software to calculate. Types of application software. There are many types of application softwares like Microsoft Word. Microsoft Word helps you to create documents with ease and efficiency. Microsoft Excel. Microsoft Excel helps you to perform calculations and store the data in a tabular form. MS Paint. MS Paint helps you to work with graphics. You can draw and paint with the software. Logo. Logo is a software program used to draw different shapes and figures using different commands. You can also use it to do simple calculations. Children, all these things, all these softwares will be doing in the further chapters of our book. Now come to the diagram, the adjoining diagram which is there on the page. Again the same diagram which we have seen in the previous page. Here is a green pointer which is pointing towards the application software. So application software is in the context of user, and the user chooses which software does he want to work with according to the need. Suppose you want to make a drawing, then you will be choosing the MS Paint. You want to write a document, you will be using MS Word. If you want to make tables, keep your contents in the table, you will be using Microsoft Excel. So these softwares are called application softwares. Let us read the further page, the next page, that is page number 21. System software. System software is a type of software that controls and manages the overall activities of a computer system. Therefore, a system software is like a manager of a computer system. It operates from behind the screen and ensures that your computer system functions properly. It also runs the application software. Operating system is a part of system software. Operating system is a software which acts as a bridge between the user and the computer system. It is the first software which has to be installed onto the computer. A computer is useful without the operating system. For example, if you have a car which has petrol, engine, wheels, but if there is no driver to drive the car cannot move on its own from one place to another. The driver acts as operating system for a car, so an operating system is must to work with a computer. Functions of an operating system. An operating system controls processes and approves everything that happens on your computer, such as controlling hardware. An operating system controls all parts of a computer system and enables them to work properly. Now come to the diagram. Here you can see a pink circle where system software is written. So operating system and utilities are the part of system software. Children, these are the specific software, these are the specific programs which are mandatory for the system. If these programs are not there in the system will not work. Right? So these are some functions. I will explain some functions of the system, of this operating system, the system software. The first is controlling hardware. Now let us take an example. If a user wants to take a printout and he is using MS Paint, obviously he will give a command to take a printout. That command, that print command, will go to the system software, means the operating system, which is there in your system. And this system software will make the hardware to take a print. Right? It means The hardware part of the computer is controlled by the system software or an operating system, which is a part of system software. Whereas the MS Paint, which the user was using, that was an application software. The system software is mandatory to be there in the system, whereas application software will be of your choice, will be of user's choice. Let us read page number 22. Running software. An operating system runs application software such as MS Word, MS Paint, Logo, games, etc. Booting. One of the major functions of an operating system is booting. It is the process of starting and restarting the computer. Booting is of two types, cold booting and warm booting. When a computer is switched on, this process of booting is called cold booting. The process to restart a computer that is already powered on is called a warm booting. Now, types of operating system. Popularly used operating systems are Windows, Macintosh, and Linux. Windows. Windows is the most efficient GUI, that is graphical user interface based operating system from Microsoft. It controls the overall activities of your computer. Mac operating system, that is Macintosh operating system. Mac OS is a series of graphical user interface based operating system developed by Apple Incorporation for their Macintosh line of computers. Linux. Linux is an operating system that is available for free on the internet. Linux is an open source code operating system. It can be copied and modified free of cost. Let us revise this page once again. The main thing which I wanted to repeat, that is warm booting and cold booting. Warm booting means restarting a computer that is already on, whereas cold booting means a cold boot means starting a computer that is already off. Now you can see two buttons here. Cold booting, a circle with a vertical line, that button will be pressing on the CPU for cold booting, whereas the picture given in the red part, that button will be pressing on the CPU for warm booting. So children, this is all about this chapter. So next time when you come to the computer class, please keep your computer books and pencils with you so that we can do the exercise of this chapter. Thank you and have a nice day.